dragons. No two Ollivander ones are the same. Put your hand down. Just as a note, do you know horns? Dragons. Well, phoenixes are quite the same. Now, you never get such good results with another wizard's wand. Ethan, step close to the light, please, so I can see you clearly. Thank you. Good. Ah, yes. Wand of Hazel. Now, a wand of Hazel is 13 inches. This wand is flexible. Now, this wand has... Oh, this has a dragon heartstring core. Take this in your wand arm, please, Ethan. Thank you. Now, would you bring the ladder to me, please, Ethan? Give your wand away. Say, Archeo ladder.
Archeo ladder.
Very good. Apparently not. No. Oh, wand of Hawthorn. Yes. Now, wand of Hawthorn. This one is 13 and a half inches. This one is reasonably springy. This is a unicorn head. Take any wand on. Oh, there's a bell up there by the door, Ethan. Do you see it? I want you to ring that bell, but just one time. Give your wand away. Go ahead. Marvelous! No, definitely not. This is curious, I mean, it's always been clear. Well, to those of us who've studied wand law, that the wand chooses the wizard. Oh, I wonder. Now, this wand is quite rare. It's considered unlucky and unpopular. It's a wand of Elder, it's 14 inches and rigid. Phoenix tail for the call, and for the right wizard. That's the perfect fit. Now, that wand provides protection against physical or psychic attack, and can undo evil magic. It's perfect for someone who is strong and prosperous. And with a phoenix tail feather call, you are truly destined to make a mark, Ethan. If I may, now my assistant Brianna will answer your questions and special options, but before we go, remember the wand learns from the wizard, and the wizard from the wand, from Brianna. Thank you for selecting Ollivander's food.